Okay, so hello again. In this video we shall start cloning our Raspberry Pi image. Now there are a few ways you can do this, but given the feedback I've gotten by the testers, I have chosen a very simple method that uses a USB drive. So the idea is that if you're using an image or if you're using an SD card that's 16 gigabytes in size, that you can compress it to an 8 gigabyte sized image by using an 8 gigabyte sized drive. The other way to do this is by using a live Linux system on your Windows machine, which proved to be a little bit too complex for my testers. So I will take an 8 gigabyte USB drive, and the idea is you just connect it, or you just insert it to the Raspberry Pi. You can ignore the window that pops up, and you go to Start, Accessories, and you go to the option that says SD Card Copier. Now you are here now presented with two options. The first option is says copy from device, and it should say internal SD card. The other option says copy to device, and there's only one option in here, and that's going to be the USB drive I'm going to copy to, so I select that one. Now be careful when doing this, because it will, first of all, it will erase all content that's on the USB drive, and secondly it will also repartition that pen drive. We now click Start. Now it gives you that warning message, so you click Yes, and now it's preparing the USB drive and will start partitioning it and start writing the data to it. Now the advantage of copying it to an USB drive is actually that you compress it a little bit, and by compressing it you can, like, you will spend less time writing the clones to the actual SD cards. Now this might take a few minutes, so I'll pause the video here and I'll come back to you later. Okay, so copying took about just under 20 minutes, and it's nearly done, so I will wait for the confirmation message. Okay, and now it says copy complete. Happy to hear that. Then press OK. We can now close this window, and we can just take out the USB drive with the image on it, or with the clone on it. Next up, you insert the USB drive in your Windows machine. And I'll now leave the Raspberry Pi and enter the Windows operating system. So this is now the content of this USB drive. I'll close the folder, and I want to save it in a folder called clone. What I'll do is I'll simply copy the path to that folder, paste it in here, and I will add the name of my image file. So I will write custom underscore node dot img. It's really important that you append dot img to it, otherwise it will just write out the file and not an image that can be used later on. Now the second thing you have to do is you have to check the device. I only have one option, so I choose that one, and this letter should correspond to the letter of the USB that you've inserted in your computer. Now this time you'll have to choose read, and it will now start the process of writing the image from the USB drive to my custom node. I'll pause the video here and pick it back up when it's finished. Okay, so the process of writing the custom node image on my laptop hard drive has been completed, and what I did is I've just taken out the USB drive, I've inserted a blank micro SD card in my laptop, and the file path to the image is still inside of Win32 disk imager. Now what you want to do now is you want to write the data that's inside of this image 2my or 2D SD card. So you select the option write. It then gives you an error message saying that writing to a physical device can corrupt the device, and that target E, which is now the letter that corresponds to the micro SD card, is the target device. Are you sure you want to continue? I say yes. So in the next videos we'll do two more things. First of all, we shall make each of our nodes identifiable. For this we'll use the file of Pi-Lib that's called device.ini. And we shall also learn to expand the file system. And finally, and that's going to be a separate video as well, we shall create an auto start entry for the Pi-Lib software. So see you soon.